Prodigal Steve returns to Stardew Valley. How's it going, everybody? Last episode, we acquired easily my favorite piece of furniture and perhaps my favorite item in the game altogether, and that is this majestic chicken statue. This episode, I don't have a whole lot of plans, honestly. I feel like lately we've been neglecting our social relationships a little bit, so maybe we'll spend the next couple of days talking to people. See, it's gonna be Tuesday and Wednesday. There's not a whole lot going on those days. Like, Friday would ideally be a little bit better day to do this because everybody's gonna be at the bar. Or, I mean, maybe not everybody, but a lot of our villagers are gonna be at the bar. Harvest this pepper real quick. But really, we're in a pretty good spot altogether, so we can afford to take a Tuesday, Thursday, or I guess Tuesday, Wednesday, rather, to just hang out and talk to people. And I mean, I know I have kind of been avoiding it a little bit, expressly because I want to, you know, show as many of the cutscenes as I can, but so far, this system has yielded exactly zero cutscenes, so it might be a good idea to change it up a little bit. We're actually going to be a little short on water. That's okay. All right, get the rest of these crops watered, and then the rest of the day is ours, so let's go ahead and look. We might be able to get the scene with Pam. I'm not sure. I don't know who else I want to talk to, honestly. Kind of want to go talk to the wizard. Yeah, I'm gonna come say hi to you here in a second. There you are. Yeah. Did we check mushrooms last time? I don't remember. We did probably fairly early in the morning, it looks like. I think the more those are pulsating, I guess. It's a weird way to describe that, but that means the closer they are to being done. I could be wrong. That's based pretty heavily on anecdotal evidence, but it seems that way to me. Let's pop into town real quick and see if there isn't a quest available for us. That'll give us something else to do today. There is. Let's see how much I care about it, though. Rainbow trout. I don't know how to catch a rainbow trout. I'm sorry. Sebastian is my half-brother, if you didn't know already. I did know already. We look totally different. You're not wrong. That'll happen with half-siblings sometimes. It can happen with real siblings as well. So we talked to Maru. Who else do we want to talk to today? It's still early in the day, so, you know, people are just starting their days, really. We can come in here, sell this pepper to Pierre, and talk to him, though. You can have that. Close. Sometimes I get new items in stock, so make sure to stop by every so often. It's a lot of work to run a shop. I'm sure it is. Let's go talk to Carolyn. Should I wear something special to the aerobics meetup today? Oh, that's right, they have aerobics on Tuesdays. Okay, you're just gonna say that forever. That's fine. You know what? Okay. George is at 2 hearts. I'm pretty sure we have a leak back on the farm. But I kind of want to get the first scene with him before we start giving too many gifts. Looks like another gloomy day. Dude, it's nice outside. Day is what you make of it. George is always a little less grumpy in the summer. The warm weather softens his bones. You might not be able to tell, but I can. I've known him for 60 years. Okay, fair enough. I was just going to say that he doesn't seem any less grumpy to me. But goes to show what I know. Thanks for putting me in my place. What's up, Pam? Oh, it's Mr. Steve. Do you need my help or something? No, just drop by to talk. You're like one of my favorite people in town, apparently. How did I become mayor in the first place? It's a long story. I got nothing but time. We're both too busy for stories right now. Somebody thinks his garden is more important than interacting with townsfolk. Do I have anything here with Clint? I don't think so. What's up? No, no, I do not. Yep. I come in here, do the shopping thing, and then just leave. Let's talk to the guy. If you want me to upgrade your tools, you'll have to give me the correct ore. I'm aware. And you'll have to pay me a fee, of course, naturally. You know, if you're good at something, never do it for free. Let's head down to the beach real quick. I don't have, like, any big plans for today. You know what? I'm gonna check the beach. I'm gonna talk to these two. What's up, Haley? Ew, you're all dirty. Well, I mean, I do live and work on a farm, so I don't necessarily know how to fix that situation. Like, I don't have a shower or a kitchen or anything. If my hair wasn't so popular with the ladies, I swear I'd shave it all off in a second. Sigh, life can be tough. Well, I mean, that seems like a problem you've made for yourself. Like, you're putting a lot of emphasis on how other people perceive you, as opposed to doing necessarily what you want to do. So, I don't know that that's necessarily life being tough so much as you making life tough for yourself. But, you know, what do I know? Let's go unload this stuff with Willy. We can have a conversation with him. Then I'm going to go talk to Robin and see about maybe making some farm buildings. All right. You can have all of that stuff. Thank you for the money. I appreciate it. A true angler has respect for the water. Don't you forget that. I will endeavor not to. Quee. Okay, you know what? I was very confused at the idea of birds wading in the ocean, and then I recalled that birds can actually, you know, swim, sort of. Hey, Leah. The sound of farm animals is great, isn't it? Yeah, I mean, I guess. It's like a pretty vague thing, though. You know, the sounds that chickens make are vastly different from, say, the sounds that cows make. So, ooh, copper ore. That's fine. Alright, I don't think I ever finished the thought. No, maybe I did, about going and talking to Robin and getting farm buildings, but she's not going to be there because it's Tuesday and she has aerobics. Right. Sorry, shop's closed for the day. I'm at Carolyn's place for aerobics club. Right. Well, I think we probably have what we need to make a silo. Have you come to ridicule me? I have not. I'm just minding my own business. Okay, well, carry on, man. I don't know why you think I dislike you so much. The air is so thick with honey and nectar all summer, I almost feel dizzy. It'll happen, I imagine, you know, rural area like this. Surrounded by nature, especially up here, you know, by Robin's house and stuff. There's a lot of nature over in this general neck of the woods. Okay, 12 iron ore. What time is it? 2? Almost 3 o'clock? I think I might head to the mine briefly, try and get some more iron ore so we can upgrade our axe. Because it did just now occur to me that I want to remove that log before we put a silo in. That way our farm is laid out a little bit nicer. I have a feeling a lot of people tend to put their farm buildings immediately to the left of the actual house, and then it kind of bisects the property strangely. Like, it's inconvenient to get from one side over to the other. Okay, can you stop slowing me, please? This is actually horrendous. Okay. I would just love some iron ore if you could find it in your heart to give it to me. We had, what, 12? We need... It's 5 ores for, right? It's, 5 ores per bar and 5 bars per... why am I looking for a staircase? For upgrade, there we go. I'm sitting here, reaching for that word this entire time. So we're gonna need, I've done the math, it's 25. But I was looking for the word upgrade. So we're actually about halfway there, just shy. That's gonna help out a lot. We'll grab this quartz, because why wouldn't we? Ooh, this is gonna help a lot. We might actually get there. I was a little skeptical at first because, it's later in the day. Either way, we won't be able to submit it for upgrading until tomorrow, because Clint's going to be closed already. Ooh, that was my bad. I take ownership of that hit. I wish there were more knockback on this hammer, though. There we go. I kind of expected to not be standing inside that slime for the entire fight. All right, so that's going to give us... 31 iron ore. We might as well head back and smelt this stuff up. Then we can submit our axe for upgrading tomorrow. And immediately after that, we'll start building a silo. So it's not going to happen on this episode, but we're planning for the future. We're making headway into having a little bit more productive and functional farm. So I'm excited. It's going to be good. I think we're going to start with chickens. Yeah, we can go talk to Sebastian real quick. We haven't seen him in who knows how long. I'm looking forward to the cold, damp season. I feel more at home. I agree. I'm not a fan of the summer. We've had this discussion, not you and me specifically, but, Sebastian and I... you, the viewers, and I have had this conversation. I don't do well in the heat. I don't enjoy it. I have a very high natural body temperature as it is. So when the air temperature is also very high, I'm doubly uncomfortable. Where am I going? I need to come over here and smelt some iron. Winter, however, and fall even, much better for me. Even if it is, damp and what some people would consider unpleasant. I don't want to be in menus for too terribly long here. Just because I do eventually want that to smelt. We're not going to get most of it done today. Which is fine. We can smelt the rest of it up in the morning. Despite how much I would prefer to have it done today. It just isn't going to happen. Iron takes too long. I mean, we could build... Yeah, we might as well build another furnace, right? Now, in my off-camera playthrough, I have my furnaces in this room, and I think I might do that again. I like it being self-contained like that. It's a... It looks a little bit nicer, it's more aesthetically pleasing on the actual farm proper when they're, buried inside this cave instead of out in the wild like this. But for now, this is fine. We're not going to need more than, 2 furnaces in the foreseeable future. At some point, we will want more than that. I had, 6 in my off-camera file, and I think that's fine. You can do 1 upgrade, cycle per set of furnaces, plus a little bit extra. Admittedly, though, at that point, I was mostly smelting copper bars for kegs and or tappers to really make just tons of money. Yeah, Yeah, this is what I want to get rid of, because I want a stone fence like right here running along the bottom of that pond. Then silos, like three or four of them going in a line down this fence. Then we'll have a path coming straight down from the house, like from the door, straight down this way. And then the buildings will be on like either side of that. Or maybe they'll both be over on this end. I haven't decided yet. But right now that is the plan as far as our buildings go. Okay. I'm going to call it a night for this first day. Those will be done smelting in the morning. Then we'll just have to do one more. And we can start that before we do our chores. Can I not sleep with the... Oh, apparently I can't sleep when I'm holding something over my head. I did not know that. Ooh, we got level 5 foraging. Wood is worth 50% more, or chance for double harvest of foraged items. I feel like this is going to be way better. Like, I don't ever sell wood for money. Like, there's just too much other stuff that you can do with it. However, a lot of the foraging stuff, once we've donated to the community center, it's just, you know, free money, basically. And that might actually encourage me to plant these summer and spring and autumn seeds and so forth. Alright, clear and sunny tomorrow. Perfect for the luau. Oh, we're gonna have the luau tomorrow. Okay. Well, that's gonna be exciting. Open next episode with an event. Spirits are somewhat annoyed today. That's fine. Ooh, we got some mail as well. Tomorrow we're all gathering at the beach for the annual Pelican Town Luau. The highlight of the event is a communal potluck. Make sure you bring something good to contribute. The governor himself is attending the event, so make sure you're on your best behavior. Come to the beach sometime between 9 a.m. and 2 p.m. Okay, I have an idea of what I want to bring. I want to find some grapes, so I'll look out for those today. Because I put grapes in the first time, I think. I'm pretty sure it was grapes that I put in the first time, and the governor loved it. So I'm going to try and emulate that again. If it doesn't work, like if I'm misremembering this, well, such is life, I suppose. Oh, I had talked about how we were going to smelt the bar first and then do the rest of our chores, and then I just started watering right away out of a force of habit. Alright. Might as well do both of those, put all this stuff away. Oh, the charcoal kiln. I was very confused about what that was. I thought it was a furnace when I just kind of looked in the chest briefly. I was like, why did I make another furnace when I had one just sitting in the chest? But it turns out I didn't, so that's why I made a new one. Get this stuff watered. Then we'll head down towards the forest, I think, in an attempt to find a grape. We'll also go talk to Clint about our brand new axe. And we can make a stop in to see Robin as well. Oop. Just to double check exactly what we need for the silo. I don't think it's much. Right, so that's done. Hopefully our other iron bar is done. It is not. Well, I'm going to pop up here real quick and go talk to Robin then, I guess. By the time I get there, she should be tending shop, as it were. I was hoping to find a grape, honestly, on this path on the way back here. That's okay, we can cut down and around a different direction to get home. Okay. Construct farm buildings. I know I looked at this just the other day. 100 gold, 100 stone, 10 clay, and 5 copper bars. Okay, that's very doable. I think we might have the clay. I would hope we would. And we have a ton of copper ore. So that's not going to be hard to accomplish. We'll grab this sweet pea real quick. It's not exactly the forage that I was looking for, but it'll do. All right. Hopefully we can snag a grape. So, oh, we got 2 gold star sweet peas. I don't think that's worth a lot of money, but you know, getting a free one on top of it certainly helps. I'm gonna go check over here by the bus stop. Hopefully we can find a grape up in this area. We can on occasion. Hopefully today is one of those occasions. Not just a ton of sweet peas today. Got a spice berry. Is this another sweet pea over here? It is. I wasn't sure if it was one of the background flowers, kind of like this guy over here. All right, all that stuff is getting just dumped straight into the shipping container. And then we're going to head out to talk to Clint. Oh, we're going to have so many blueberries. I'm so excited. We should be getting pretty close to them being productive as well. Let's go ahead and start making some copper as well. Oh, I should check for that clay while I'm thinking about it. We have 25 clay, so next episode... No, maybe not next episode, because it's going to be the 12th when we get our axe back. So yeah, we can do it at the second day, assuming that Clint counts tomorrow as a work day. The event might push things off a little bit funnily, so we'll see. After that, we're gonna stop at the beach real quick because I wanna look for shells, and then after that, we'll head down to the forest by Leah's and Marnie's and hunt for a grape. I guess I could look in my like chest by the house as well, see if I have any forage in there, but I doubt it. All right, upgrade tools, steel axe. Why do I feel like I did this exact thing just the other day? I can't upgrade my axe because I can't afford it. That's right. Okay, well, I'm gonna put like a sticky note on my TV. Steel axe costs 5,000 gold. Remind myself. That will get sorted out fairly soon. Not soon enough, unfortunately. We might be able to just build a silo south of that log, you know, just like wait for that one and build the next one down. But I want to make sure my spacing is appropriate. We'll talk to Robin at like day two of next episode, because I doubt she'll be accessible. Although she might be, if we take the northern path around, we might be able to get up to Robin's despite the luau. And actually, we might have full access to town because it's on the beach. This morning, I accidentally stepped on a bug. That's unfortunate, but you know, we do. You especially, you live by the river, so I imagine that there are a fair number of insects in the vicinity of your home. I don't imagine encountering bugs by your residence is that uncommon. It must be satisfying to follow your crop from seed to harvest. It is, kind of. It's as if your essence is infused into the fruit. I guess? It's a unique way to phrase that sentiment. But I mean, you're not completely wrong. I would really love to find a grape. Just like one grape. Ideally a gold star grape, but I don't know if that actually matters. I wonder if there's like a window for grapes. Like maybe they're just the first part of the season? Because we found grapes, right? That's summer crops. Yeah, this would be summer foraging. So we've already found grapes for sure. We're like, you know, a third of the way through the season. So maybe grapes are beginning of the summer. Maybe they're just a lot rarer than the other foraging. We could plant summer seeds. But I don't know. I don't know how I feel about that. Just to, like, it's going to take too long anyway. Like, it doesn't do us any good for the luau. This is actually fairly unfortunate because I don't know what else to put in there. Like, I don't particularly want to, you know, just drop a fish or something in the potluck soup thing. Those look like grapes. Why can't I have those grapes? Okay. I think I've poked around most of town. Well, let's come up here back to the farm. We'll see what we have laying around, because I don't know if any of this stuff is going to be harvestable by tomorrow. We have a leek, we have a winter root. Strawberry, I mean, we could put a strawberry in there, right? Let's get rid of a bunch of this stuff. No, that we don't need, that we don't need. We don't need any of that. I don't think a flower is going to be what we want to add to the potluck. Like, hey, remember that weird farmer? He fed us flowers for the potluck? I'd rather not be known as that guy. What about mushrooms? Ooh, we have a ton of them. And some of them are actually fairly rare. Do I have the... Ooh, I do have the life elixir recipe. I just need a purple mushroom, which I don't know if we can get from these. I wanna say you can, but I don't remember. We might have to go down to the caves for those. That's gonna be what? Four? Oh, that's gonna be six copper, so that's fine. We have plenty of stone. No, it's not what I want to do. Okay, that's better. I'm trying to remember the shortcuts. You know what? Actually, this is going to be a lot quicker. We can go up to 200. And then... half it. Perfect. Okay. Now that we have most of the ingredients for our silo, take that. I didn't want to... There we go. What do we need? 21? Then shift click. Okay. I want to make... maybe I don't necessarily want to make the stone fence right now. But I kind of want to space this out. Like, this is going to be fence. And then this block is going to be silo. And I think those are three? One, two, three. So it'd have to be, like, right here. Yeah. I think this is going to be maybe our first silo. We'll build it, like, right there. So we can go talk to Robin, hopefully at the beginning of next episode, and if not, at the back half of the episode. There we go. I just hit spacebar to pick that stuff up. I was playing Don't Starve. Well, Don't Starve Together, actually, this morning, so I'm still accustomed to having to actively pick things up and not just auto-collect them. Alright, let's drop this stuff off. Our copper should be done. We need another pine cone. Okay, that's fine. Yeah, let's take this and this. Oop. Store one of those, store all of these. There we go. I should have checked what a coop requires as well, now that I'm thinking about it. That's an oversight on my part. I don't have really anything else that I absolutely want to get done today, and I know it's a little bit early, but I might go ahead and call it for the night, you know? Let's run into town real quick, see if we can't talk to some people. I'd rather use the time for something semi-productive than just cut the episode a little bit earlier than I would intend to. Do we check for a new quest today? No, there isn't one anyway. Do we have any birthdays that I missed? Oh, is Maru's birthday today? Oops. It's my bad. Who is at the tavern? Presumably Pam is here. Clint is also here. Hey, what do you need? Just saying hi, man. No, I don't have time to chat with you. All right, well, carry on drinking alone then. I like that all of you, you all have to know each other, right? Like, you two live together. You're related. You can use a scythe to cut feed from grass. Or you can buy it from me, of course. I could use the cash. Adios. Fair enough. Having a local farm is good for our town. Thank you, Pam. That's very kind of you to say. It doesn't rain much in summer, does it? That just means more watering work for you, huh? Or do you enjoy the sunny weather? I mean, it's okay. On occasion, it does storm, which is fine. I like to use those rainy days to fish or go into the mines because, you know, I have a little bit of extra energy. But, you know, that's some metagame stuff that you're not overly interested in, I would imagine. All right. Pam's at 4 hearts now, and I don't think we've seen a single scene with her. This is unfortunate. Well, yeah, I think that's going to do it for this episode. I think we're just, it's getting a little bit later. Not much else to do, so we'll have the luau next episode and some other stuff. So yeah, that's going to do it. If you've enjoyed this video, consider hitting the like button. As always, feedback is welcome in the comments below. And if you want to see more videos like this, consider subscribing to the channel. And I will see you next time.